The annual gala had a different look and feel this year due to the pandemic, but through shared interests efforts since 1994, it has provided loans in excess of 1.9 billion rand, impacting the lives of some 2.3 million people, particularly women in the Southern Africa region. But a public health emergency of international concern has threatened those gains. And their longtime executive director will step down from a position she's held since 1994 at the end of this year, had this departing message.
In this pandemic, our model really matters because it mobilizes countries' own resources by guaranteeing local loans to otherwise excluded Black borrowers. With travel and international assistance uncertain, Southern Africa must rely even more on its own institutions to help these lifeline businesses survive, grow, and sustain their communities. The last 25 years' progress is at stake.
They urge donors to continue to support their work, providing microfinancing and unlocking credit, first to South Africa's low-income communities of color, and later with partner Tembani International Guarantee Fund, expanding their work into neighboring countries.
Women in Southern Africa have played a significant role at this time when things are so hard. They have been shouldering the fight against the virus. They have been addressing food insecurity. They have been addressing gender-based violence. And women entrepreneurs have also been fighting to save their businesses. Thank you for being part of the struggle in Southern Africa.
Please work to strengthen the ecosystems of support for smallholder, family, and subsistence farmers. Take decisive action to involve youth in agriculture. Rebuild sustainable indigenous food systems. Increase public financing for food security. And last, but not definitely not least, invest in the irreplaceable and strategic place of women in food security.
On a night that honored stalwarts of South Africa's women's movement, with Shared Interests Ubuntu Award going to someone who's been both an ambassador at home and abroad.
I accept this award on behalf of all the little girls and boys who are growing up in Soweto. I accept this award in the spirit of Ubuntu, humility and humanity, the spirit that exudes Nelson Mandela. Thank you, Dana Katzen and my Shared Interest family, for making the dreams of this little girl from Soweto a reality.
The last living leader of the Seminole Women's March in 1956 received the Imbokodo Award, while urging the next generation of women leaders to fully take the reins.
At the time of the march, I was a young, energetic 18-year-old. I soon understood the power and value of intergenerational alliance in pursuing and defending our mission against oppression of race, class, and gender. And I am proud of the efforts and progress my generation have made. We have, however, so much more to do.
And as the world works to build back better, efforts here to ensure that gains made in the last 26 years don't all come to naught. Sherwin Bryce-Pease, SABC News, New York.